According to the legend, while on a business trip to Japan sometime in the late 1990s, the infamous musician-turned-producer-turned-television mogul Haim Saban happened to catch an episode of Japan's long-running Super Sentai children's action series and had a crazy idea. Edit American actors into the non-action footage, dub the rest into English, and release it in the United States. The result, 1993's Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, was an instant smash hit and became one of the most popular and profitable kid franchises of all time. So naturally, Saban and company decided to make the magic happen a few more times, finding mixed success with series like Masked Rider, VR Troopers, and Big Bad Beetleborgs. But prior to that, in fact right around the same time they were prepping the original Power Rangers, they'd also been getting in on the ground floor of what was then the emerging American market for anime, snapping up the US rights to a relatively obscure Tatsunoko series called Cat Ninja Legend Tayande. As with Power Rangers, they wound up being some serious translation overhauls, though this time the reason why was a much more interesting story. Because
TV is weird.
Alright, so there are some conflicting accounts as to exactly how all of this went down, but here's the basic idea. Cat Ninja Legend Tayande was actually not a huge success in Japan. It did okay, but it only ran for one 54-episode series, and was pretty lightly merchandised compared to a lot of its peers, and as such, it was never properly prepared for any kind of international release, and the production materials, supposedly including some of the original master tapes, weren't especially well preserved. So when the US production team, assembled by Saban, sat down to start translating, they discovered they had a lot less to work with than they were expecting. Oh, they had all the shows, but depending on who you ask, the original scripts, audio, story notes, and pretty much everything else containing important information, like, oh, what the plot was, who the characters were, or what any of them were supposed to be saying or doing, was either incomplete, poorly translated, not translated at all, or simply non-existent. So goes the story, the dub team's only option was to watch the untranslated episodes, try to figure out what was supposed to be happening and what the relationship between the various characters were supposed to be, and then, well, just make the rest of it up. And thusly, the Samurai Pizza Cats were born.
Samurai Pizza Cats!
Oh yeah!
Who do you call when you want some pepperoni?
Samurai Pizza Cats!
They're so bad, they've got more fur than any turtle ever had!
Here's the thing, though. While the original show was pretty basic anime, anthropomorphic animal kid action fare, it was, well, very Japanese, with visual references and iconography grounded in tropes and formulas of manga and Japanese pop culture immediately familiar to its original audience, but not familiar at all to the dubbing team. So goes the tale, they ultimately decided that the best way to translate the weirdness before them was to just play it for comedy. So while Cat Ninja Legend Tayande had been a mostly straightforward talking animal fantasy show with some kid-oriented slapstick, Samurai Pizza Cats took the form of something closer to Animaniacs or SpongeBob. Peppered with fast-paced verbal humor, groaner one-liners, pop culture references, fourth wall-breaking asides to the audience, and just shy of naughty humor for the adults. Like the Oath, for example.
We kittens are a special breed. We never call retreat.
Whenever Big Cheese knocks us down,
we land upon our feet.
So hail to thee, O Pizza Cat! Please ring your little bell! Although you may be pen and ink, we know you'll fight like
Pizza Cat!
Yeah, that's right. Samurai Pizza Cats was essentially its own abridged series. And yes, their samurai armor has little cat bells. That's awesome. What was it about? Well, it all took place in Little Tokyo, a retro-futuristic version of feudal Japan populated entirely by talking robot animals. Gee, I can't imagine what about that seemed so bizarre to the dubbing team. The ostensible ruler, Emperor Fred, is in actuality a well-meaning idiot whose power is manipulated by his corrupt, not-so-secretly evil prime minister, the Big Cheese, who schemes to seize power via his private army of ninja crows commanded by his underlings Bad Bird and Geriatric. Yeah, get used to the funny names, folks. It's like 90% of the humor. To protect the royal family from Big Cheese's machinations, Counselor Big Al Dente, see what I mean, secretly maintains his own team of armored superheroes, the titular Samurai Pizza Cats, who operate in secret via their civilian identities as pizza delivery men. These are our heroes. Of course, the theme song introduces them so much better than I ever could.
There's Speedy Cerviche, he's the leader of the bunch. A heck of a fighter, makes a heck of a lunch. And little Polyester, who's never afraid of going into battle with the bad guy. Here's Guido and Toby, a wild romantic rover. This cat gets down with a love hangover.
Though the revised English dub was completed in 1991, it didn't actually start to air most places until much, much later, not until 1996 in the US, when Power Rangers had turned Saban into a kids' TV juggernaut. And wouldn't you know it, the joke-laden, satirical redub actually clicked with audiences. To this day, while the original series is barely a footnote in its own country, this funny version was a big hit in some territories, and remains a cult classic with anime fans. Even the original creators are alleged to have said they thought it was better as a spoof. Since the original TV run, though, the show has remained a bit hard to come by. Saban sold the rights to most of its kids' TV brands to Disney in the early 2000s, which is supposedly why the characters weren't able to turn up in Tatsunoko vs. Capcom. But recently, Saban bought all their material back and, along with the long-awaited DVD releases of the original seasons of Power Rangers, have announced a complete DVD release for Samurai Pizza Cats later this year. Heh, you know, I can't help but wonder what else might have been better if someone had lost the script. I'm Bob, and that's The Big Picture.